Hello, my name is Tomasz and I am solution architect at Codeline. Welcome to part two of our series of AI for networks, in which we would like to show you some examples, some ideas, how to benefit from using artificial intelligence and machine learning techniques. The first part, I talk about network capacity planning. It's already up on our channel, so you can watch it right after this video. And today I would like to focus on improved alarms in terms of root cause detection and filtration of non-meaningful alarms. Alarms arise in case of errors and failures on devices, and very often such an event causes explosion of alarms of another devices. Usually we are observing such explosions of alarms, and the problem is how to indicate the primary reason, which is called also the root cause. We would like to do it as fast as possible in order to mitigate the overall problem. Here we could also use some machine learning techniques to improve the process. Contrary to the normal usage of the, say, past data, we could not expect that such events are often. So in general, we have lack of such data, because the failures and errors and explosions of alarms are too rare to collect appropriate amount of data that could be analyzed and inferred some after the events. So in this case, we have to use another type of data, which we call the graph representation of networking or data center environment. And this is usually the huge graph that in the nodes we have the devices. By the edges in such a graph, we are representing the relations between such a device's elements. Such a graph representation is quite complex, but we need to use it to extract some patterns, which is in the simplest form, it is, for instance, device failure and the list of the affected elements by such a failure. It is not an easy task to extract such a patterns, but this is affected elements, in fact, represent the explosions of alarms. We need to interpret them and to determine that the root cause, the primary reason, was on particular device. And here, plethora of techniques can be used also. There are some techniques of graph ML, when you could process such a data and to extract such a patterns. Usually we will have a lot of such a patterns, and in the case of such a event, we have to quickly determine the root cause. Having such a patterns, also another techniques, machine learning techniques like clustering, like classification, can be used to help us quickly answer the question of the primary reason. Let's look at the simple example when we have the network and we have device one, which is failed. Usually it means that all the links connected to this device are failed. So we will start receiving the alerts on neighboring nodes, neighboring devices, that something is wrong with particular links. So we have the explosion of alerts, and just after detecting that such a link, for instance, is failed, the nodes will start using the alternative paths to forward the traffic. That may cause another types of alarms related to overloading. In that way, we could see what will happen in this area of network. In time, we are receiving alarms on devices, and this is our pattern. This is our pattern that we need to input to our models in order to answer the question. And in the perfect situation, we would like to determine that the failure was on the one. But very often it is not possible. Very often we will limit the potential reasons, potential root cause to a set of devices or the set of the alarms indicating the root cause. This is one use case. In another use case, I would like to focus on filtration of non-meaningful alarms. In the episode one, I was saying about the measuring of resource utilization, but we also could measure some KPI on our services. And usually, in order to determine that something wrong is happening with our observed element, we are defining thresholds, and over which and under which, if a particular metric is crossing the threshold, then we would like to be alerted that something is wrong. But in general, the setting the right level of threshold is not an easy task. And very often we have the situation that improperly set thresholds causes that alerts that are not meaningful. So they are not very serious in our environment, but we are spending time for handling them. In this case, we could use also some machine learning techniques. The first step is just to collect data about past alarm handling. How to achieve such a data is another problem. But for instance, we could use a trouble ticket tracking system to retrieve the information how particular alerts were handled by our staff. And here, machine learning techniques could be used for filtration of such alerts, or to adjust the thresholds levels. Let's look at the example when we have an example service API, and we are measuring response time. And let's assume that at the beginning we set the alarm threshold level at 7. And when we are observing the latency, we are receiving a set of alarms when the actual value is crossing is above this threshold. If we collect information how particular alerts were handled by our administrators, and also adding some additional features, for instance, what was the ratio of the actual value to the threshold level. But the most important feature is if our administrator took some actions for particular alerts or not. Based on such data, we can train a classification model. And when we have a candidate for next alert, we can evaluate its importance. We can say that it is expected that it need to be handled, or maybe it is not important alerts. This is one way we could use machine learning techniques. Another way is to analyze such data and to evaluate the right level of the thresholds, separating important from non-important alerts. Like here, for instance, we can deduce that the alarm threshold should be set to 11. In that way, we will receive only 3 important alerts. Just to summarize the use cases, for sure, if we are able to use some techniques to faster detect the problem that is causing the explosion of alarms, usually we are saving money because we could faster repair the situation. In the second use case I showed is that we could help our administrators to classify alarms that need to be handled, or from those that when we have a little crossing to the thresholds and in generally we are not able to react on that. That will save precious time of administrators. In general, it should improve the overall operational efficiency in terms of alarms handling and should lead to reduced operational costs. Thank you for watching. And if you have any questions, please feel free to share them in the comments section. In the next episode, we will focus on another use case when we could use external data to solve some particular problem. In particular, we would like to show you how to shorten the fiber cut recovery time using external data. The first episode is up on our page, on our channel that you could see after this video. And please stay tuned on our next episode.